let's move over to Joseph and check out these amazing temperatures that we've been having. And also out at Seaside, it looks like that's a sign of things to come there, all that rain.
That's exactly right, Wayne. Yeah, it's been a mild air mass associated with this atmospheric river. So it's been moist out along the Oregon coast. Some of that rain's going to arrive for us here in the valley. But today we just had those warm temperatures out there, some record-breaking temperatures. Yeah, if you kind of spot this area right here and you focus your attention, you'll notice the rain, and then the kind of the camera is pretty damp too. That's been raining in that direction of the state for some time. Today and yesterday, they had more of the brunt of the rain. We only had some passing showers at times. Okay, here's Portland right now. We have the overcast conditions. It's not too wet just yet, but as I mentioned earlier, I think we're going to see this pick up in steam after midnight, so probably about 4 a.m. is going to be the chance for some steady rain. So that's out of the coin tower tonight. Temperature is still at 59 degrees. The record tomorrow, by the way, is 58. If we could hold on to 59 or 58 beyond midnight, we'll tie that record, or potentially we could even beat it. All right, there's the stream of moisture. It's been kind of settling down in shifts here as we've gone through the day today. Still a little wet to the north of us, but we'll eventually tap into some of that moisture as a front moves on through later on tonight, and that's when it will really engage some lift for us and things will become a little more organized. Radar is picking up on some moisture, though, especially into areas of Clark County through the Cascades into Washington and the foothills, extending through Cowlitz County there, and then you can see some very light rain around Portland. So it is definitely possible, starting about now, that we have some very light rain. We haven't had anything measurable yet, but to the northwest we definitely have. It's been a busy day up there. Not even a drop off towards the east, but I do believe Pendleton, you folks will eventually get some of that rain. We had a couple flood advisories up there. Now this is what's remaining to a river to the north. It looks like those have expired, but we're going to keep an eye on that section of the state of Washington over the next couple of days because they're just dealing with some flooding issues. Tomorrow we do have some rain, likely just for the morning, but then we have a spree of days where I believe it's going to be pretty dry out there, kind of like today. Hey, I want to show you this video. This is from Pauline. She sent this in. This is a wonderful shot here. This is some drone footage. I just love capturing this train as it comes towards us, but it's also showing those clouds that were streaming in today. That's all in front of what is going to arrive late tonight. So this is a wonderful video there. And again, as always, thank you. All right, so FUTURECAST, as we head into our Sunday night, there's that rain. It's matching up with the radar. Stays pretty consistent. Early tomorrow morning, we may have a couple showers hanging around, but I think once we get through sunrise and somewhere around 7, 8, 9, it really starts to slow on down. And then we stay pretty dry. The rain stays to the north of us from Tuesday all the way to probably about Friday or so. All right, 57 tomorrow for the high, 55 on Tuesday, mainly dry, maybe some rain in the beginning of the day. 60 degrees on Wednesday with some sunshine, and then Wayne, we finally bring temperatures back down to normal by the time we head into next weekend with some overnight temperatures back into the 30s as well.
Yeah, maybe we can start getting some snow up in the mountains again. That would be a nice thing.
Yes, for the ski resorts. We'd love that.
Yeah. All right, next.